Google's Nano Banana Pro just made it possible to create videos like this from a single image. I mean, look at Elon's profiles here. The sweater details, his diamond watch, the Doge ring. I mean, he's completely iced out. This entire video was made using Nano Banana Pro and Kling. It took about 20 minutes. And today I'm going to show you the exact prompts and system I use so you can create videos like this for yourself. So for this video specifically, I use three tools. I use Higgs field to generate the frames with Nano Banana Pro. I use Kling to turn those frames into video clips. And then I used EasyPeasy Ease to stitch everything together into one video. The whole process takes about 30 minutes once you know what you're doing. So with that said, let's get into it. Okay, so we're inside of Higgs field, and the first thing that we have to do is generate the base image that will essentially work as the foundation for the contact sheet. So you can see right here that we have some of these opening shots that I was playing around with, and I really liked the style of this one. As you can see right here, I will put the prompt on the screen as well. We basically just went through the prompt. We uploaded a photo of Elon with the Supreme sweater and this watch right here. And by the way, I will leave a link in the description below to all of the prompts so you can use them to create videos like this for yourself. And if you need custom AI systems or help with AI content, feel free to book a call by clicking the first link in the description below. So we have this image right here that we essentially wanted to use as the base or the foundation for the contact sheet. So what I did is I downloaded this image and re-uploaded it into Higgs field along with the prompt to generate the contact sheet. And then we started getting some of the output, as you can see right here. Some of them obviously didn't come out really good, but a lot of these were really cool. And the one we ended up with was actually this one. So we have six really unique and pretty cool shots here. We have the opening shot of him just staring at the camera, and then we have some of these unique angles where we have Elon sitting, we have him standing right here on top of the box, we have this side shot, we have the close-up with the glasses, and then we have the extreme close-up of the Supreme sweater. So the next step after this is essentially to start extracting all of these individual images from this main contact sheet into their own image to start generating the video clips. So we basically go through and extract each of the six base images right here from the contact sheet to single them out into their own image, as you can see that we were doing right here. So we start extracting each of the opening images. So we have first one right here, which is him just staring at the camera, that we have with this image right here. And then we basically just start going through and extracting each of the other images from the scene. So we have this sitting one right here. We have the one of him standing on the box. Then we go through and start extracting the side profile image. We have the close-up of him with the glasses. And then for the final one, we have the image of him, or basically the close-up image of the Supreme sweater. Then I started generating a couple of new images where we have him again, the base image right here, and then a close-up of the Rolex watch that he was wearing. And we basically wanted to generate this wrist shot of Elon where he's pulling down the sweater a little bit to show the iced out Rolly, and then you obviously see the Doge ring as well. Then we have this wide angle worm's eye view. We're basically creating this standing scene where we're really focusing on the shoe right here. And essentially we're just creating a couple of more scenes from the initial reference image that are outside of the contact sheet, or basically to create a couple of extended clips that we can then turn into video and Kling later. Then we move on and start generating some of these images where he's pulling out the Game Boy Advance from his cargo pants. You can see that some of these obviously didn't come out great. Like here, the Doge ring is obviously off. We have a couple here where he's sitting, which doesn't really fit. But this one came out really good where he has it halfway out of his pocket. The details on the Doge ring is obviously spot on and everything looks really good. And this one is fitting as well because the previous image is obviously of him standing. So we need to have it kind of like fit where he pulls out the Game Boy from his pocket from a standing position. So we ended up with this one right here. And then for the two final shots, I basically just wanted to play around with adding some grills to his teeth right here. So we basically just have, again, the base image. We took a different one, which is basically the opening shot from the contact sheet. And I also added some grills right here. And then we basically just have the prompt of him. The model is smiling, showing the grills on his teeth. And then we got this one. And then for the final image to close out the entire video, I basically just wanted to kind of like have this funny image of Elon with some of the gang signs or some of the gun pistol hand shots right here. So we basically just took, again, one of the reference images, this one where he's also clearly showing the Rolex and the Doge ring. And then we just have the prompt here that the model is standing, making a gangster pose with his hands as if he's shooting a gun. Again, not super amazing, but this one came out really good. You can see again, the details are pretty solid and everything came out very, very detailed and specific, which is what we obviously need. So that lays the foundation for all of the images that we want to now turn into videos. So now we are done with Higgs field. We have all of the images using Nano Banana Pro inside of Higgs field to generate all of the shots and the scenes that we want. And then next is now moving over to Kling, where we now animate these scenes and turn them into a video. Okay, so we're inside of Kling, and for this specific video, I use Kling 2.6. You can obviously play around with the different models that are available, but for this specific one, I basically just wanted to use one of the newer models that also allows you to have a first frame and last frame, and Kling 2.6 is perfect for that. And this is the opening scene of the video, and you can see right here that the prompt is really simple. We have the prompt here that the camera very slowly and smoothly lowers on a boom, the subject barely moves, and you can see right here that we have the opening frame of Elon standing, and then we have the end frame, which is the second scene from the contact sheet, which is him sitting on the box. And you can see that this is the final output. Very simple, very clean, very smooth with the transitions, where we have the opening scene, and then it ends with him sitting on the box, which is our second image. And then we basically just go through scene by scene. So if we open up this one, the opening shot is him sitting on the box. And then we transition into the third scene from the contact sheet, which is him standing on top of the box. And again, the prompt here, very simple. The camera very slowly and smoothly lowers on a boom. The subject barely moves and is extremely deliberate and thoughtful in movement. And again, it's super smooth, super clean with the transitions from the opening frame to the final frame. Then we basically just go through, and then obviously, as you can probably see, from each video to the next one, the opening frame is the last frame from the previous shot. So in this case, the opening frame here is where we have Elon standing. This was the end frame from the previous video, and that obviously gives that smooth transition from the previous frame into the next one. Here we can see that we have Elon. This one obviously didn't come out great, so I think we had to recreate this one a couple of times. And as you can probably see, each opening frame from each new scene is the end frame from the previous video, which allows for that seamless transition. So in this case, we obviously open up with the frame of Elon standing on top of the box, and then we end with the frame of him in the side pose. And again, prompt, super simple. The camera very slowly and smoothly moves to the end frame. The subject barely moves. Then we move from the side profile into the close-up of him with the glasses. Here I tweak the prompt a little bit. We have the camera very slowly and smoothly moves to the end frame and zooms in on his face. So I basically just add a little bit of specificity as to where I want the camera to zoom in, which is on the glasses, and that obviously fits up nicely with the end frame here as well. Then we move on to the next scene, which is obviously the zoom in of the Supreme sweater. Again, I specified the prompt a little bit, but it's pretty much the same as always. We have the camera very slowly and smoothly moves to the end frame and zooms in on the text. The subject barely moves. And again, you can kind of like see the very clean and smooth transition from the opening frame into the end frame with the Supreme text. Again, same thing. The opening frame here will be the end frame from the previous video, which is the zoom in of the sweater. And then we have the end frame for this one being the wrist shot. Here again, I do specify the prompt a little bit, basically that the end frame shows the model flexing the watch. The subject barely moves. And as you can see, all of these prompts are super simple. We're trying to have the models not moving too much in the video to kind of like get that very smooth and flowy vibe that you can see from the video. Again, we have the opening shot of the wrist shot and with the frame of Elon standing with the worm shot focusing on the shoe. Again, we just switch up the prompt a little bit. So we have the end frame focuses on the shoe. The subject barely moves. Again, very simple. And then we obviously open up with the worm shot of Elon standing with the shoe. And then we transition into the video of Elon pulling out the Game Boy Advance. As you can see, you kind of like have that little bit of gray that kind of like doesn't really fit the Game Boy Advance. But due to the transitions and how we kind of like stitch everything together later, it's not super noticeable, but I did try to generate this a couple of times and this was the best video that I got. You can also see that, again, the ring here kind of like messes up a little bit, but I mean, it's obviously not perfect, but again, due to kind of like how we stitch the video together and how we do the transitions, you don't really notice it that much. Then we move on to the shot of him pulling out the Game Boy and then just standing looking at the camera, which tees up the next scene very nicely. And again, the prompt is super simple. We have the end frame focuses on the man and the subject barely moves. Then we move on to the smiling scene, and obviously right here we can see that the opening frame is the same as the end frame from the previous video, and then the end frame on this video is Elon smiling with the grills. Again, super simple prompt, we just have that the end frame focuses on the man's teeth smiling, the subject barely moves. And then for the final scene, we have the same opening frame as the end frame from the last scene. And then we have the final frame of the gang signs or the gunshots. And then we have the same prompt, but the end frame focuses on the man pointing and the subject barely moves. So that's how we generate all of the video scenes using Kling 2.6. As you can see, the key here is to play around with the prompting so you get that smooth movement that you want. And now for the final step, we move over to EasyPeasy Ease, where we now upload all of the video generations and stitch everything together. Okay, so we're inside of EasyPeasy Ease, and this is basically just a software or a tool that I found on X where you can basically just upload all of your video clips and it automatically stitches them together and generates that very smooth transition vibe that you saw in the video. So you can see right here that I'm just going to upload all of the 11 video scenes that we have right here. So we have the 11 videos all uploaded in the correct order. So we're just going to finalize and stitch the videos together. Okay, so let's take a look at the current output. That's pretty spot on. I do want to have the duration be a little bit longer. I wanted them to be 2 seconds each. I'm just going to apply this to all the videos. Then we're just going to update this again. Beautiful. Okay, let's take another look. Beautiful. And now obviously for the last step, if you want, we can add in some audio. I already have a track downloaded, which was the one that I used in the initial video, which is the Drake song. So I'm just going to re-upload that and then update video. Flip, flip. I don't know nobody else that's doing this. Body start to drop, ay. Hit the floor. Now they want to know me since I hit the top. Ay. This a rollie, not a stop. Watch shit don't never stop. This the flow that got the block hot, shit got super hot, ayy. Give me my respect, give me my respect. I just took it left like a flip. Perfect. And there you have it. That's the entire video. Now you can just download it and upload it to any platform that you want. But that's basically the entire system. So there you have it. That is the full workflow to create multi-angle videos like this from a single reference image. And if you like this video, feel free to drop a comment below on what you want to see next. I'm always testing new AI tools and platforms, and I would love any feedback on what you guys want to see next. And if you're running a business and you want custom AI systems built for you, feel free to book a call by clicking the first link in the description below. But with that said, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you guys in the next one.